Port Miami. How does it make money? In this lesson, we'll analyze the 2017 financial statements of the Port of Miami. We'll pay close attention to its operating revenue and its sources. We'll also look closely at Port Miami's Tariff No. 10, which outlines the various prices, fees and charges the port levies on its users and their cargo. In 2017, the port had operating revenue of almost $167 million. Operating revenue at the port comes from these seven business segments. As this chart shows, some segments are clearly more sizable than others. Let's start by looking at the port's cargo operations. In 2017, the port had total container volume of over 1 million TEU. Which ranked it as the 12th largest container port in America. Cargo operations at Miami contributed to the port's operating revenue in two main segments. The first is cargo wharfage and dockage, as shown here in red. The second is container crane user fees. Miami owns and rents out 13 container cranes to various companies at the port. Together, these two cargo-related segments generated 20% of the port's 2017 operating revenue. Let's look at wharfage first. Wharfage is a charge levied by a terminal or port when goods are moved through its location. Port Miami's tariff document outlines the wharfage charges for different types of cargo. This includes automobiles and motorcycles, which it charges wharfage of $10.61 per unit. On containers, the port charges wharfage of $38.75 per TEU. Let's look at container crane rental income next. The Port of Miami owns and rents out 13 cargo cranes. Container crane rental rates are outlined in the Port Miami tariff document. 1 hour of crane rental costs $879 during regular hours. As we saw earlier, these two cargo-related revenue segments generated 20% of the port's total operating revenue in 2017. Next, we'll look at Port Miami's cruise operations and the revenue that they generate. Port Miami is the largest cruise port in the world. In fiscal year 2017, the port welcomed 5.3 million cruise passengers, setting a world record. One reason for Miami's cruise passenger success is its proximity to the Caribbean, the world's number one cruise destination. As we saw earlier, in 2017, Port Miami had total operating revenue of almost $167 million. Cruise wharfage and dockage, as shown here in dark blue, accounted for well over half the port's total operating revenue. Put another way, in 2017, cruise wharfage and dockage revenue were almost 5 times greater than cargo wharfage and dockage. Let's look at cruise wharfage and dockage revenue in more detail. We saw earlier that wharfage fees are levied on goods as they move through the port. We also saw that Miami charges wharfage of $38.75 on each TEU of container cargo. Wharfage fees are levied on cruise passengers too. As Miami's tariff document shows, the port charges wharfage on each cruise passenger of $12.37. Let's look at an example. The Carnival Vista has a capacity of almost 4,000 cruise passengers. At full capacity, the Carnival Vista has potential wharfage fees of almost $50,000 each time passengers embark or disembark from the ship. Miami also charges dockage fees to both cruise ships and cargo vessels that use its docks. Cruise vessels are charged 38.2 cents per gross ton for each 24 hours that they are docked at the port. Let's look at an example of how dockage fees would be applied to a cruise ship at Port Miami. The Carnival Vista has a weight of 133,500 gross tons. That means that dockage fees at Port Miami for a vessel the size of the Carnival Vista would be almost $51,000 per day. Miami's 5.3 million annual cruise passengers contribute to the port's bottom line in other ways too. One additional way that they contribute is through parking fees that they pay at the port. Parking fees at Port Miami are outlined in its tariff document. With over 5 million annual cruise passengers using the port each year, parking fees add up to be a very meaningful part of Miami's total operating revenue. In 2017, parking fees contributed almost $14 million to Miami's total operating revenue. In fact, parking fees contributed slightly more to the port's total revenue than the container crane user fees that we looked at earlier in this lesson. Next, we'll look at the revenue that Port Miami produces through rentals. The port rents out office, warehouse and terminal space. It also rents out equipment as well. Examples of the various rental rates that it charges are shown here. Of the port's total operating revenue of almost $167 million. Rental income accounts for a sizable 13% of the total. The objective of this lesson was to better understand the sources of Port Miami's operating revenue. By analyzing Miami's 2017 financial statements and tariff sheet, we were able to discover some important facts about the port. We saw that cruise wharfage and dockage at Miami account for almost 5 times more operating revenue than the equivalent cargo wharfage and dockage fees. We also learned that Miami's 5.3 million cruise passengers contribute to the port's bottom line in other ways too. This includes parking fees, which account for 8% of the port's total operating revenue. Together, these two cruise-related segments accounted for 64% of the port's operating revenue in 2017. And finally, at the beginning of this lesson, we saw that Miami's cargo operations make up an important part of the port's total operating revenue. As we saw earlier, these two cargo-related revenue segments generated 20% of the port's total operating revenue in 2017. The port industry is in the middle of competitive change. Port Miami has recognized the need to adapt and adjust if it wishes to remain competitive in the future. To ensure that the port responds and succeeds to the challenges it faces, Port Miami developed a strategic plan called Master Plan 2035. To learn more about Port Miami's operations in 2017, its tariffs and pricing, and its plans for the future, download these documents in the links we've provided in this course.
Thank you.